I'm Prabhakar. Now we'll discuss the analytical method of addition of two vectors. In the analytical method, we resolve first the vector itself, each of these vectors. Say for example, in the xy plane, I have a vector A. This vector A is resolved into two perpendicular components, namely, draw perpendicular here. Along the x axis, it is written as AX vector. The y component is indicated in the y direction as AY vector. Now, in the figure, vector A can be written as A, vector A is AX vector plus AY vector. Now, AX vector and AY vector are called the vector components along the x and y direction. Now, these vectors are also written in this form, AX I cap plus A y j cap. Vector A is equal to A x I cap plus A y j cap. What are this I cap and j cap? They are called unit vectors along x and y direction. I is the unit vector along x direction, j is the unit vector along y direction. What is this unit vector that we are talking about? Now, go back to this definition itself, equation 1 and 2. If you see, A x vector is replaced by A x I cap. What is I cap, which is called the unit vector? Vector unit vector I is vector A x divided by A x. What does that mean? It means the vector divided by its magnitude gives you the unit vector in that direction. It is called I because it is along the x direction. So, in the figure what I am going to indicate is unit vector I, its magnitude is unity. Why? Because the magnitude of the AX vector is AX and it is being divided by AX. Therefore, I by definition is a unit vector along the X direction. Similarly, we indicate unit vector along the Y direction which is given as J. Please note, I is the unit vector along X direction, J is the unit vector along Y direction. I and J are perpendicular unit vectors. In three dimensions, we also have along the z axis, say for example, in the figure, we indicate in three dimensions, when you have x, y and z in space, you have unit vector along I, unit vector x along I, unit vector j along y direction, unit vector k along z direction. This is the standard representation that is used to represent vectors along these three mutually perpendicular directions. So, vector A is written as AX unit vector I, which is read as I cap plus AY J with a cap. They are unit vectors. Now, how do I use this in adding two vectors? Vector A is being resolved into two components along x and y directions as shown here. Vector A is written as AX vector plus AY vector. Now, this is one method. Now, this component method, now I can write let the angle be theta. Now, when I write A vector as AX vector plus AY vector, then it means square of the magnitude of the vector A square is from the Pythagoras theorem, as you can see, when you apply it, you get it as AX squared plus AY squared. So, if you know the component of the vectors, then you know the magnitude. then the magnitude of the vector itself is square root of ax squared plus ay squared. That is the magnitude of the vector. Now, what about the direction of this vector in terms of components? Now, if you look at the triangle, tan theta is ay magnitude by ax magnitude. So, theta can be found out as tan inverse, that is, if you know the magnitude of ay and x, you know the magnitude of tan theta, then theta can be obtained from the table, from the looking at the tan table. That is written as theta is tan inverse ay by ax. A vector, if the components are given, you know the magnitude as well as the direction of the vector. Now, how is it used for vector addition? We are going to study how resolution of vectors can be used for addition of vectors. Now, look at the diagram here, which has vector A and B represented in the xy plane. The sum of this vector A plus B can be obtained by graphical method, which you have studied earlier, by joining the starting point to the end point of B, which gives you the vector A plus B. Now, this we have done earlier. Now, what is this component method? Now, look at this vector A plus B. How can we obtain by the resolution method? Now, vector A, if you resolve it along x and y directions, it becomes something like this. This is AX component and this is AY component. Similarly, the vector B can also be resolved into x and y components. Look how we are doing it in the figure. B vector is resolved along x and y directions. This is the B vector. This is BX. This is BY. So, this vector B is BX vector plus BY vector. Now, because BX and AX, because if I bring it parallel down here, that is the same as BX vector. So, this vector is BX vector. Now, it means AX plus BX along the same direction. So, I get the vector as AX plus BX vector, that is, this is the vector. Now, similarly, AY and BY can be added because they are in the same direction. It is easy to add two things if they are in the same direction, then the sum will be simply the beginning of one and the ending of the other. So, this will be the vector AY plus BY. So, look at this. In this diagram, along the x axis, you have AX plus BX. In the y direction, you have AY plus BY, and that is same thing as this vector. Now, it means I can write, look at this. The vector A can be written as AXI, that is along the x direction, plus AYJ, that is what it is. Now, similarly, B has been resolved into two components, one along the x direction and along the y direction, that is written as BXI plus BYJ. So, the vector A plus B from the diagram, you will see this is AX and BX. So, this is the vector AX plus BX, and along the y direction, you have AY plus BY. So, that vector AY plus BY can be written as AY plus BYJ because AY vector is AY into J vector. So, AX plus BXI is the component along the x direction, AY plus BYJ is the component along the y direction. Therefore, vector A plus B is simply AX plus BYI plus AY plus BYJ. Now, because the components are there, vector A plus B can also be written as, if you write it as vector C, then it's, if these two vectors are same, then the components, namely CX vector, must be AX vector plus BX vector. Now, that's what you are getting in the diagram. Now, similarly, CY vector, that is the component, which is some, if I write it as C, this must be equal to Cx is equal to Ax plus Bx Cy, the component along the y direction, which must be equal to Ay plus By. So, in the component method, the vector sum, which is sum of A plus B, can be written as C in the component form is Cx plus Cy, A in the component form is Ax plus Bx, that is A, B can be written as Bx plus By. It means if these two represent the same vector, then it means Cx must be equal to Ax plus Bx, because the components must be the same. Cy must be equal to Ay plus By, and that is what we saw in the figure. So, the component method is simpler compared to the graphical method if you know the components. Vector C, the sum of the vectors A and B, if I write it as vector C, C must be equal to A plus B. Vector C in the component form will be Cx plus Cy. Vector A in the component form must be Ax plus Ay. Vector B in the component form must be written as Bx plus By. If Cx must be equal to, then vector Ax, that is the x component of the vector along the x direction, plus B component of the vector in the x direction, which is Bx. Similarly, the component of C in the y direction is Cy, must be equal to the sum of the component of y along Ay vector plus By vector, and that is what we saw in the figure earlier. So, look at the figure again. The vector C has x component, which is the sum of Ax and Bx, which is written here. The vector C, the component of this vector in this direction is Ay plus By. So, the vector sum of these two vectors, that is A and B, the component sums, that is Cx vector, is equal to sum of Ax vector plus Bx vector. Similarly, Cy vector must be equal to sum of Ay vector plus By vector. So, the component method helps you to solve this problem easily instead of drawing as per the graphical method, because the graphical method is a little tedious method when it comes to the geometrical constructions. The component method of vector addition, that is resolving the given vector into two components along x and y directions, similarly resolving the other vector into two directions, is an easier method compared to the graphical method, where actually the drawings must be drawn according to a certain scale. This is an alternative method which is called the analytical method of vector addition. Till now we have studied about vector addition. In the next lesson, we will study the operation of multiplication of vectors.